In this video, I'll discuss the concentration change when you dilute a solution or you add another acid or when you add a base to it. So, the first case I'm considering for the dilution . Suppose we have a solution which is, say, 0.5 molar HCl and it is 200 ml, right? And you are dividing it into two parts, or say, let's just say three parts, that is 100 ml and 40 ml and 60 ml. Now, when you divide a solution into three equal parts, the concentration doesn't change because the concentration is uniform in throughout the solution. So, if you divide it in all the three parts, the concentration is same. That means the concentration remains at 0.5. Here it remains as 0.5 and here also it remains as 0.5. There is no change in the concentration. Now, if you want to find the number of moles that are present here, here, here and here, that will be different. So, number of moles I can find from the molarity formula as 0.5 into 0.2, because our unit is in liters. I have to take it in liters, so I get this as 0.1 moles. I have considered the unit remains, I mean the concentration remains same, so this becomes 0.1, so here it is 0.05, this becomes 0.5 into 0.04, this is 0.02, and this is 0.5 into 0.06, that is 0.03. Now, if you see, if you add the 3, you get 0.1, which is equal to the number of moles which was present before you divided the 3. Now, what if I add some amount of water to this? So, let's just say I had 0.5 molar HCl. I have 0.5 molar HCl and 100 ml and I am adding 100 ml water to it. Now, we have three quantities, concentration, volume, number of moles. Now, in this case, you can think which will remain constant and which will change. Obviously, the volume is changing. Now, once the volume is changing, my concentration should change. Why? Because my number of moles doesn't change. I mean, no other amount of acid is added to it. No, or if this acid is not divided also in different parts. So, simply my number of moles will remain constant until unless you divide it or you add to it something. When you divide it, that means you are subtracting it. Or if you are adding to it something, that means the number of moles increases. But here in this case, nothing of that sort is happening. So, number of moles remains same, my volume changes and so my concentration will also change. So, let's just find the number of moles here. I get that as 0.5 into 0.1, that is 0.05. So, here the number of moles remains same. Now the volume is what? 100 plus 100, 200. So I get this as 0.2. So that gives me, initially it was 0.5, now it will be 0.025. You can see the concentration has decreased. It will be 0.25, not 0.5. That is why we say on diluting a solution or on adding water to a solution, the concentration decreases. Here you can see how it has decreased. There can be another case when we add two different solutions. Suppose I am adding 0.5 molar HCl of 200 ml and to it I am adding 0.5 molar HCl 100 ml. So what will be the concentration of the new solution? We have to first find the number of moles in each of them and then add them and then divide by the total volume. So number of moles for this case is 0.5 into 0.2, that gives me 0.01. In this case 0.1 into 0.01 I get 0.05. So if I add the two I get concentration as 0.1 plus 0.05 entirely divided by 0.2 plus 0.1, the volume of the first, the volume of the second. So I got 0.15 by 0.3. This gives me 1.5 by 3, which is equals to 0.5. So the molar or the concentration remains same. If you have the concentration of two acids of same compound as same and you add in two different solutions, then the concentration doesn't change. But if the concentration are different, that means I am taking 0.5 molar HCl of 200 ml and I am adding to it 0.2 molar HCl, say 100 ml. Now it will change. This remains same, 0.1, N is 0.1, and if you find this, you will get this as 0.02. On adding, you get concentration as 0.1 plus 0.02 upon 0.2 plus 0.1. That gives me 0.12 by 0.3. That comes out to be 0.4. So now you can see the concentration has changed. This is molar, this is molar. So when you add two acids of different strengths, then the last or the final concentration will change, but if you are adding two acids of the same strength, the concentration doesn't change. Now what will happen if, okay, so we have seen one formula that we often use, V1S1 is equals to V2S2. Where does this come from? Or V1S1 plus V2S2 is equals to V3S3, which is the case here. V1 is volume, S1 is concentration. If you multiply this, you get the number of moles in the first solution. You multiply this, you get the number of moles in the second solution. And obviously, that has to be equal to the number of moles in the third solution. That is what we have done so far. So, this is how you get the formula. It's from the number of moles. You put these values and any unknown you can find from here. This is what we use for finding the strength in an acid-based titration. So what do we have? Suppose we are doing the titration of HCl plus NaOH. We get water plus NaCl salt. Now we know that concentration of H plus goes on decreasing. So I am taking the concentrations as 0.1 molar 100 ml and to it I am adding 0.1 molar 100 ml of base. This will give me the concentration of H plus as what? 0.1 molar, and this will give me concentration of OH minus as what? 0.1 molar, because this dissociates into two equal parts. Now, using this, we can find the final concentration. I am going the traditional method, I am finding the number of moles. 0.1 into 0.1, I get 0.01. and this has number of moles of again 0.01. So that means 0.01 moles of OH minus consume 0.01 moles of H plus. So how many H plus or OH minus are left? That is 0. No H plus or no OH minus is left. So that means the final strength will be devoid of any H plus or OH minus ions. This is when I am taking two equal concentrations of acids and base in equal volumes. What if I decrease one of them? Suppose I am taking this as this is I am taking suppose 80 ml. I have taken 80 ml of base. So now my concentration remains same, but my number of moles changes. This becomes 0.008. So now you can see the number of acid is higher in amount than the number of base, the moles of base. So that means extra amount of acid will be left. So I can write NH plus minus NOH minus. This gives me NH plus or N dash H plus. So this is N 0.008, this is N 0.01, this was 80 ml. So I get NH plus minus NOH minus and remaining H plus. So I get 0.01 minus 0.008, I get this as 0.002. So this is the amount of H plus present. And if you find the concentration, this will be what? This is divided by total volume. Total volume is 180 ml. So 180. And you will get the answer. This is the formula that we used to use in V1S1 equals to V2S2 formula. Where this is the volume concentration of acid, volume concentration of acid. So whichever is extra, that we will get from here. Okay. Okay, so one more thing I will tell you. Most of you know what a limiting reagent. Now, what is a limiting reagent? Limiting reagent means in any titration or in any reaction, whichever thing is present in a smaller amount that gets consumed before or that gets consumed earlier than the other. So that becomes a limiting reagent because after that the reaction cannot proceed to completion. Suppose I have taken HCl and I have NaOH. This gives H2O plus NaCl. I am taking 10 HCl molecules and 5 NH molecules. So obviously all of the HCl will not be consumed because 1 HCl is consumed by 1 NaOH. So 5 NaOH will consume 5 HCl. I am left with 5, and these are 0,0 initially, and this. So 5 HCl is remaining. So that means NaOH is consumed first. So NaOH is my limiting reagent. Similarly, you can find, suppose H2SO4 plus NaOH. Whatever be the reaction, I am saying this is present 10 and this is present as 16. What if which is the limiting reagent here? This reaction is not balanced yet. You have to balance it. So this becomes 2 and we get Na2SO4 plus H2O and twice H2O. 2 NaOH needs 1 H2SO4. So that means 10 NaOH will need 20, but we have 16. That means 16 will take half the number of H2SO4, that means 8 H2SO4. This is consumed first, so this is my limiting reagent, and this will be left extra 2 moles of H2SO4. Okay, suppose we have a question here which says 0.04 moles HCl solution of volume 500 ml was filled in a beaker. This type of questions doesn't come, but these type of questions will help you understand the concepts so that you can apply it in bigger questions or the questions which come in the exams. This says that 0.04 molar HCl of volume 500 ml was filled in a beaker of 100 ml. So that means 100 ml beaker you have taken. So the maximum volume that can be is 100 ml. What is the concentration? 0.04 molar HCl. Now the solution from the beaker is transferred in a flask having 200 ml water. So that means there is a flask which is having 200 ml water, and to this you are adding 100 ml 0.4 molar HCl, so that becomes 100 ml extra volume. Now the concentration obviously will change here because the volume is changing, number of moles remains same. This is the same case of the dilution we have seen. Now suppose this is the concentration of C1. Now after that 0.2 molar HCl solution of 100 ml was added to it. So to this I am adding, this was 300 ml C1 HCl. To this I am adding 100 ml 0.02 molar HCl. So how will the molarity of the solution, final, what will the final molarity of the solution? So for that, again, this is the case of the mixture of two acids that we have seen before. So in this case, we have to find the individual moles. I can find the individual mole for this, but I need for this. For this, I need to find C1. And C1 I will get from here. So what is the case here? I can directly use V1S1 equals to V2S2 because the number of moles before remains equal to the number of moles after. So before it was 200 ml, or I can just write it in ml, and strength was 0.04 molar. Afterwards it was 300 ml into C1. So what is my C1? C1 is 200 ml into 0.04 by 300 ml. This gets cancelled, zeros gets cancelled, I am left with 0.08 by 3 molar. Right? Now I have to find for this. What do I get? I get V1S1 plus V2S2 equals to V3S3. We can use this formula. Or what we can do is you can find the number of moles for 1, number of moles for 3, 2, and this will give you the number of moles of 3, and then divide it by the volume. So this is the shortcut. So I am using the same method for saving your time. So V1S1 gave me, okay, so V1S1 comes from here, 300 ml of C1 HCl. That gives me what? C1 was 0.08. by 3 into 300 ml plus 100 ml of water, or sorry, 100 ml of 0.02 into 100. This gives me what? Total volume is now 400 into, say, C2. I need to find C2. So if I do this, I get 100, I get 8, I get 2. This is equal to 400 into C2. So I am solving this here. So what do I get? 10 by 400 equals C2, or C2 is equals to 0.0. So if you divide this, I am getting 1 by 40. That will be 0.025 molar. So this is how you can find this. There has been one question. in weight okay so this question came in GATE 2018 okay which does not involve this molar concentration term. This is related to the previous video about the solubility product and degree of dissociation. So this came in GATE 2018. It says the molar conductivity of a 0.01 molar weak acid. Now my weak acid they have given is HX. Concentration is 0.01 molar. Fine. Measured in a conductivity cell with cell constant of 0.4 centimeter inverse. So that they have given L by A 0.4 centimeter inverse. Is 64.4. That means molar conductivity. Molar conductivity here means this 64.4 Siemens centimeter square mole inverse. The units are correct. Okay. The limiting molar conductivity is an infinite dilution for H plus and X minus R. That means lambda naught M H plus and lambda naught M X minus is 350 and 410 Siemens centimeter square mole inverse. The unit is same here also. They are saying ignoring the activity coefficients, the pKa of HX is, so they are asking you to find the pKa. Now the pKa will get, if you see the reaction, this is what the reaction constant is Ka, let's just say it's a forward reaction. So I have told you pKa is what, minus log into Ka. So I need to find Ka. How will you find Ka? They are saying it is a weak electrolyte. So in this dissociation I will get initially 1 at time t equals to 0. This is 1, this is 0, this is 0. At time t equals to t, I get this as 1 minus alpha, alpha, alpha. Or if I am taking C concentration, this is C minus C alpha, C alpha, C alpha. So I get Ka is equals to concentration of H plus into concentration of X minus by concentration of HX. This will give me what? C alpha, C alpha, C 1 minus alpha. C gets cancelled, I get C alpha square 1 minus alpha. Okay, so solving Ka, solving, putting the value of alpha, I can get the value of Ka. And now I know alpha is what? Lambda m by lambda naught m. Lambda m they have given, lambda naught m for the two ions they have given, I can simply add them. So I get 64.4 divided by 350 plus 410. This will give me what? 64.4 upon, this is 760. Units gets cancelled, nothing is left here. So I have got this as alpha. Now using or putting this value in the Ka expression, I can find the value for Ka. So we have Ka is equals to C alpha square 1 minus alpha. Alpha comes out to be 0.08. So I can write 0.01 into 0.08 square upon 1 minus 0.08. This gives me 0.01 into 64 into 10 power minus 4 upon 0.02. So I am left with this gives me 32, 32 into 10 power minus 4. And the unit is the unit of concentration, that is moles per liter. Fine. Here concentration is fine. So it's moles per liter. Okay. Okay, I have done a mistake. So here we get it as 0.01 into 64 into 10 power minus 4. This will be 0.92. So if you solve this, this comes out to be 0.695 into 10 power minus 5 molar. Now I am trying to find out the pKa minus log Ka, which is minus log 0.695 into 10 power minus 5. I can divide, separate this two as minus of log 0.695 plus log 10 power minus 5. So minus log 0.695 minus 5. This comes out to be 4.15. So this is my answer. So in this way, you can find the pKa using the concentration and the molar conductance in infinite dilution of the respective ions. Please make sure to not make mistakes in the subtractions like I did, or in the units. You have to take care of the units, because in the gate, if you change the units, the entire answer will change.